أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، اما بعد، فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ذلك بما قدمت يداك وان الله ليس بظلام للعبيد. ومن الناس من يعبد الله على حرف، فان اصابه خير اطمأن به، وان اصابته فتنه انقلب على وجهه خسر الدنيا والاخره ذلك هو الخسران المبين. صدق الله العظيم. The last ayah of the first section of Surah Al-Hajj was left. When people will be thrown in the hell, it will be said to them, ذَلِكَ بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ يَدَاكَ. This is due to what your both hands had sent forward, your deeds in the life of this world. They are actually being repaid to you in the form of this chastisement. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَيْسَ بِظَلَّامِ لِلْعَبِيدِ. And surely Allah is never unjust to His servants. Now in the second section, the first ayah is very important. And this is actually the basis of the disease of nifaq. Whosoever was accepting the call of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said that, I believe in what you say, I believe you are the messenger of Allah, and I believe in Allah is the only God and there is no God beside Him, and that we shall be resurrected. Now there was persecution which came to him. People are beating him, laughing at him. If they are the slaves, they are getting the worst type of torture. So of this tribulation and testing, it became hard on some of them. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created all type of people. There are strong people also. There are weak people also. A strong person who has a strong character and he has a strong power of will, he says, this is correct, I have to do it, come what may. And he is ready to sacrifice everything. But there are certain people who want to go to the right path but are not prepared to suffer. They want to go on the right path, but to make sacrifice, it becomes difficult. So when there is a demand for sacrifice, then they fall down on their faces. This disease, when increases to a level, it becomes nifaq. But this nifaq will appear in the Madani period. But the essence, you know, that was there in the Makki period also. Some weak people who were, so to say, very much perturbed at the persecution that they were getting. They were not strong enough in nerves and their perseverance to take it boldly. So this is their condition is depicted in this ayah. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ حَرْفٍ. There are people who want to worship Allah, but on the edge. They don't want to go into the main, you know, main stream. There you might drown. So you should keep near the coast of the river. They want to take a bath, but they don't want to go into the deep waters, lest they should be drowned. So this is harf, on one corner. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ حَرْفٍ فَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٍ. If there is peace and there is, you know, all everything is okay, اِطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ. He is also very satisfied. He is going with the believers. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتُ فِتْنَةٌ انْقَلَبَ عَلَىٰ وَجْهِ. Whenever there is some test comes, and there is some tribulation, some trial from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he falls down on his face. خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. This is the loss of this world as well as of the hereafter. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينَ. This is the loss most manifest. Now the shirk of those people يدعو من دون الله ما لا يضره وما لا ينفعه. They are calling upon those deities, false deities, leaving aside Allah, who can never harm them, nor harm them, nor benefit them. ذلك هو الضلال البعيد. And this is straying far away from the right path. يدعو لمن ضره أقرب من نفعه. They are calling upon and worshipping those whose evil is nearer, ضره, loss is nearer than the benefit. فلبئس المولى ولبئس العشير. Certainly an evil protector and evil comrade. إن الله يدخل الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار. Verily Allah will make those people who believe and do good deeds enter the gardens underneath which there will be rivers flowing. إن الله يفعل ما يريد. And Allah does whatever He intends to do. من كان يظن أن لن ينصره الله في الدنيا والآخرة. This is again a psychological condition. You want to do some good work in this world, but you are despaired that Allah is not helping me. Allah is not supporting me. And if this condition, you know, goes on, you became disappointed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is actually a very bad psychological position. It's a disease. Now to such a person, a simile is being struck here. من كان يظن أن لن ينصره الله في الدنيا والآخرة. Whosoever thinks that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to help him, neither in this world nor in the hereafter. فَلْيَمْدُدْ بِسَبَبٍ السَّمَاءِ. So who is, he should stretch a rope towards the heaven. ثُمَّ لِيَقْطَعْ. And then he should cut it. فَلْيَنْظُرْ هَلْ يَجْرَبَنَّ كَيْدُهُ مَا يَغِيظْ. And then he should see whether this guile of his takes away from him the rage that he has. Now you, what's the meaning of this simile? If there is a rope and you are hanging from that rope from some height, till such time that the rope is intact, you are safe. When the rope breaks, you are down and you might be killed. So this hope to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a rope for the believer. He will help me. He will help me. He will help me. All the conditions today are very bad. They seem to be hopeless. But I never give up the hope from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe there is some turn of events and maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help comes. So this will keep you, sustain you. But if you break this, you cut this rope, you have no support whatsoever. What will you do? You are gone. So a person who is working for the glory of the deen of Allah, this is very important. He should keep his hope with Allah intact. Allah will help me, inshallah. Maybe if success doesn't come and kiss my feet in this world, at least the success in the hereafter is guaranteed for me. But what, if I'm doing what I'm required to do by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why should I, you know, why should I be very thoughtful about it? I should not be concerned. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised. If not in this world, the success of the hereafter is ensured. وَكَذَلِكَ أَنزَلْنَاهُ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ. In this way we have sent down this Quran as revelations which are very shining. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يُرِيدٍ. And verily Allah guides to the right path whomsoever He wishes. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالصَّابِئِينَ وَالنَّصَارَ وَالْمَجُوسَ وَالَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا. Now these were the groups of the people present at the time of the Prophet ﷺ. Verily those who have come to believe, they are the Mu'mineen. وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا and those who have become Jews, والصابعين, and the Sabians, والنصارى, and the Christians, والمجوسى, and the Magians, والذين أشركوا, and those who are associating false gods with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَفْسَلُ بَيْنَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Allah will judge between them on the day of judgment. Who was correct, how much wrong. All these things will be made clear and manifest on the day of judgment. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a witness over everything. Now is coming an ayah of sajda. أَلَمْ تَرَىٰ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَسْجُدُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Don't you see that for Allah prostrate everything, everyone who is in the heavens and who is in the earth. وَالشَّمْسِ. Even the sun. وَالْقَمَرِ. and the moon, wal nujum and the stars, wal jibalo and the mountains, wal shajaro and the trees, wal dawabbo and the animals and cattle, wal kaseerum minan nas, and many of the human beings also. Among the human beings, there is a division. Some are prostrating before Allah, some are not. Some are rebellious. They are in revolt against Allah. But all the other universe is obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This whole universe is obeying His laws. So as if they are prostrating before the Lord. Except for some people who refuse to do it. وَكَثِيرٌ حَقَّ عَلَيْهِ الْعَذَابِ. And there are many among these human beings on whom the chastisement has been justified. Now, it's due for them. وَمَنْ يُهِنِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ مُكْرِمٍ. And whomsoever Allah disgraces, nobody can give him any honor. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَفْعَلُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Verily Allah does whatever He intends to do. هَذَانِ خَصْمَانِ اخْتَصَمُوا فِي رَبِّهِمْ. These are the two opposing groups who are disputing about their Lord. One are the believers, others are the deniers. فَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. As for them who have rejected the call of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُطِعَتْ لَهُمْ سِيَابٌ مِّن نَارٍ. For them garments will be cut off from the fire. Cut out from the fire. يُسَبُّ مِنْ فَوْقِ رُؤُسِهِمُ الْحَمِيمُ. And boiling water will be poured over their heads. يُسْهَرُ بِهِمَا فِي بُطُونِهِمْ وَالْجُلُودُ. And with this water, everything will melt what is in their stomachs, in their bellies, and also their skins. They'll be burnt. وَلَهُمْ مَقَامِعُ مِنْ حَدِيدٍ. And for them there will be hammers of iron beating them. كُلَّمَا أَرَادُوا أَنْ يَخْرُجُوا مِنْهَا. Whenever they will like to get out of it, out of the hell, قُعِيدُوا فِيهَا. They will again be restored to it. وَذُوقُوا عَذَابَ الْحَرِيقِ. And it will be said, now taste this chastisement of burning. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدْخِلُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Now on the contrast, خَصْمَان, two groups who are opposing each other. That is going to be the end of the first. Who are the disbelievers? Now what will be the condition of the believers? إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدْخِلُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Verily Allah will admit and make enter those who believe and who have done good deeds, jannatin, gardens, tadri min tahti al-anhar, under which there will be rivers flowing. يُحَلَّوْنَ فِيهَا مِنَ أَسَاوِرَ مِنْ ذَهَبٍ وَلُؤْلُؤًا. And they will be adorned therein with the bracelets of gold and with pearls. وَلِبَاسُهُمْ فِيهَا حَرِيرٌ. And their garments would be from the silk. وَهُدُوا إِلَى الطَّيِّبِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ. And they had been guided to the best and goodly speech in this world also. Decent. وَهُدُوا إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْحَمِيدِ. And they had been guided in this world to the path of the one who is praiseworthy. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَيَسُدُّونَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Verily those who disbelieve and they are preventing people from the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What were these kuffar of Quraysh Makkah were doing? Not only that they were not accepting the call of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were preventing others also. Don't accept Muhammad. Don't go and believe in him. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَيَسُدُّونَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَالْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ. And they are stopping the and barring the Muslims from the sacred mosque also. They don't want that the Muslims come and pray in the Masjid al-Haram, in near Kaaba. They don't allow. Although they are the best rightful. They are the real followers of Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salam. But they are barred from it. So those people who prevent them from worshipping in the sacred mosque, الَّذِي جَعَلْنَاهُ لِلنَّاسِ سَوَانِ, which we have declared equal for the الْعَاكِفُ فِيهِ وَالْبَادِ, those who dwell there, reside there in Makkah, and those strangers who come from outside, both have equal rights here. And this you can see today also, when you go for Umrah and Hajj, you know, all people coming from all the corners of the world having the same rights. If some, you know, African, black African goes and sits in the first row, nobody can say to him, go back. I am from Makkah, I am a Makki, I live here, this is my right. No. The rights for all Muslims, all believers, are absolutely equal. They are treated at par. And this is what Quran is saying. الَّذِي جَعَلْنَاهُ هُتْلِ النَّاسِ سَوَابِ We have declared this sacred mosque of ours as equal for all, whether they live there, dwell there, or they come from outside and strangers. وَمَنْ يُرِدْ فِيهِ بِإِلْحَادٍ And whosoever wants to make a twist in this mosque, بِظُلْمٍ wrongly, unjustly, نُزِقْهُ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ We shall make him taste a very painful chastisement. وَإِذْ بَوَّانَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ This is Surah Al-Hajj. And here you will find two sections of this surah devoted to Hajj. We have two sections of Surah Al-Baqarah, 24-25, devoted for the ceremonies and rituals of and rites of Hajj. And two sections of this Surah Al-Hajj. This is Makki surah and that is Madani surah. وَإِذْ بَوَّانَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ الْبَيْتِ And when we showed and pointed to Ibrahim alayhi salam, the place of our house, as I told you, it was built by Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, but then it was demolished and destroyed due to floods. There were no signs. But the foundations were there. But these foundations Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disclosed to Hazrat Ibrahim that build again on these foundations. When we pointed to them, disclosed to them the place of our house, Allah tushrik bi shaya. And when you reveal this house, what will be the principles? Don't associate with me anything, anyone, number one. Wa tahir baitiya. And keep my house clean for those li taifeen who come here for circumambulation. Wal qaimeen. And who come here for standing in prayer before us, wa rukai sajood, and those who bow and prostrate before us in this mosque. So you have to keep it clean. Now this cleanliness had to be two dimensions. Internal cleanliness, that there should be no shirk over here. There should be tawheed, pure tawheed here. And number two, there should be no filth. People when come here, they should feel, you know, that they are at a very good place. Not that they are troubled by some bad smell or something else of that type. Some, you know, is there which is not very pleasant. And this work is being done to the best of their capacity by the present rulers of Saudi Arabia. In other respects, we differ with them. And they are not, you know, for us, you know, people who can be liked. No. Their luxuries and their spending extravagantly, billions and billions of dollars on one palace. And in that palace, the king comes only once a year for 5-7 days. And so much, you know, staff over there, everything, pomp and show. This is not Islam. Then, you know, the dictatorship, kingship, people have no right. They have no say in the matters of the government. So this is not Islam. But whatever good they are doing, we must accept. Number one, the service to Quran, publishing of Quran, in very beautiful forms, and distributing millions of the copies of Quran to people without any price. And number two, the service to the Haramain, the extensions that have taken place, how much money they have spent is unimaginable when you go and see. So actually this, and they keep it clean. There are hundreds of people working day and night over there, cleaning. Otherwise, such a big crowd coming there. Even children are there, they don't bar them. So, but it remains clean, very clean. And tahira baitiya, wa tahir baitiya li taifeen wal qaimeen wa rukai sujood. Number one, you keep it clean from shirk. Number two, you keep it clean also for those people who come for tawaf, circumambulation of the house of Allah. And you know, who stand in prayer and who bow down and who prostrate. وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ And now give a call to the people for Hajj. How he might have called? No loudspeakers, nothing, no communication channels, nothing of the sort, no IT, nothing of the sort. But he called. He stood up at some high place and gave the azan. Come for this Hajj. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala conveyed his voice to people far and wide, far away. And people started coming, performing Hajj. And azan fil nasi bil Hajj. You call, give a call to the people for Hajj. Yatuka rijalan. They will come to you on foot also, wa ala kulli zabirin, and on very lean camels, yatina min kulli fajjin amiq, which will be coming from through the mountainous highways, which are very deep, deep valleys. They yashhadu manafi'a lahum, so that they come here and witness the benefits that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to this place, and the spiritual benefits that they can have while, you know, performing Hajj or Umrah. لَيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ وَيَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ. And then they should mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on cattle which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. عَلَى مَا رَزَقَهُمْ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ. In the fixed days, those fixed days are the 10th of Zulhajj, Yawmun Nahar, then 11th, 12th and 13th. These are the 4 days during which you have to make sacrifice. Either goats or sheep or camels or cows, etc., etc. وَيَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ فِي أَيَّامِ مَعْلُومَاتٍ عَلَىٰ مَا رَزَقَهُمْ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا. So eat you also from that. وَأَطْعِمُوا الْبَائِسَ الْفَقِيرَ. And also feed the disappointed poor persons. ثُمَّ لَيَخُذُوا تَفْصَهُمْ. Then they should remove their unkemptness, because in ihram, you know, they might have been very dirty ihram, people coming on camels or coming on foot from very far off areas in the month of, you know, summer months, etc. So, and in the ihram, you know, there are so limitations, certain limitations. So now you might be full of dirt, your hair. Now you can, which we say, now you finish your ihram, so you can take a bath. So go and respect and ثُمَّ لْيَقْضُوا تَفَصَهُمْ. They should end their unkemptness. وَلْيُوفُوا نُزُورَهُمْ. And fulfill their vows. وَلْيَتَّوَّفُوا بِالْبَيْتِ الْعَطِيقِ. And then they should go a circumambulate round the ancient house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is Tawafu Ziyarah on the 10th of Zulhajj. After giving the sacrifice, then, you know, people go, they take a bath, they put on good dress, and then they go and circumambulate and make tawaf of the house of Allah. This is called tawaf ziyarah. Zalik. This it is. This is settled by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the rites of the Hajj that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching you. وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ حُرُمَاتِ اللَّهِ فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَهُ إِنَّ رَبِّهِ. Whosoever respects the sacred ordinances of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it is better for him. With his Lord, when he returns to his Lord, he will get the reward. And all the cattle have been declared permissible, halal for you, except the one which has been told to you many times, and that is, you know, swine, pig. Otherwise, goats and sheep and cows and buffaloes and camels, all these can be sacrificed. أَوْهِلَّتْ لَكُمُ الْأَنْعَامُ إِلَّا مَا يُطْلَى عَلَيْكُمْ فَاجْتَنِمُوا الرِّجْسَ مِنَ الْأَوْثَانِ. So you should shun the abomination from the idols. فَاجْتَنِمُوا قَوْلَ الزُّورِ. And shun the speaking of falsehood. This is the moral aspect of Hajj. Not only these rituals, but also you have to be away, keep away from these idols, false gods, and keep away from telling the lies and something which is not true. Hunafa lillah. And you should be straight and upright, exclusive for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ghaira mushrikeena bihi. Without making anybody anything associating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa man yushrik billah. And whosoever associates some false god with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fakannama kharra min as-sama. It is as if he has been thrown from the height. Fatakhtafuhu at-tayr. So now either the birds of prey in the air, they are snatching it away. أَوْ تَهْوِي بِهِ الرِّيحُ فِي مَكَانٍ صَحِيقٍ. Or the wind sweeps him to a remote place. He has no support. If he is committing shirk, if he is attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with tawheed, Allah will support him. Allah will help him. But otherwise, he has no support, no help. Zalik. This is as it is. وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. And whosoever respects the sanctity of the symbols of Allah, emblems of Allah, Shairullah, Quran is Shairullah, Kaaba is from Shairullah, and these sacrificial animals are also Shairullah. لَكُمْ فِيهَا مَنَافِعُ إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. In these animals and cattle for sacrifice, you have benefits for but till a fixed time. When you are taking the animals, well, you can ride on them, no harm. If some milk animal is there, it's a cow, you can drink the milk. But when, summa mahilluha ila al-bayt al-atiq, then the final place where it must be sacrificed is the ancient house, near the ancient house. Actually, Marwa, the hillock, that was in the olden times the place of Ziba. But then, you know, when Mecca started, you know, becoming bigger and bigger and bigger, then it went to Mina. Otherwise, this Marwa was the place of sacrificing animals. وَلِكُلِّنْ جَعَلْنَا مَنْسَكَنْ لِنْ يَذْكُرُ اسْمَ اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ مَا رَزَقَهُمْ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ. And for every ummah, we had fixed and we had prescribed the devotional rites of sacrifice so that they should mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the cattle that Allah has given them. فَإِلَاهُكُمْ إِلَاهُ وَاحِدٌ. But the essence of all this is Tawheed. Your Lord is one Lord. فَإِلَاهُكُمْ إِلَاهُ وَاحِدٌ فَلَهُ أَسْلِمُوا. So surrender to Him. You are sacrificing animals, but not surrendering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What's the use? You have sacrificed, you know, a very good, for example, a very good animal, and you have spent maybe thousands in Pakistan, in 50,000 rupees of a very good camel, very good, you know, goat. But whatever, the taqwa is not there in you. You are not surrendering yourself to the will of Allah. So all this you are spending goes in vain. Allah doesn't accept. The ayah is coming. فَلَهُ أَسْلِمُوا وَبَشَّرِ الْمُخْبِتِينَ. And O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, give glad tidings to the hosts who are humble to Allah. الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبَهُمْ. Who are those? That when Allah is mentioned, their hearts tremble in fear. وَصَابِرِينَ عَلَىٰ مَا أَصَابَهُمْ. And they persevere and bear whatever comes to them because they know it is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From none else than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَالْمُقِيمِ السَّلَاةِ. And the establishers of salah, وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفَقُونَ. And whatever we have given them, they spent. وَالْبُدْنَا جَعَلْنَاهَا لَكُمْ مِنْ شَعَائِرِ اللَّهِ. These camels for the sacrifice, them also we have declared to be شَعَائِرُ of Allah. They are the emblems and symbols of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَكُمْ فِيهَا خَيْرٌ. You have benefits out of it. Well, when we sacrifice the camel, where will the meat go? To your poor people, they will eat it. For a very long time, I think, till very near past, the sole source of income of those people living here was the sacrifices of the Hajjaj, the pilgrims. Nothing was grown over there. No farming, nothing of this sort. You know, the Hajis used to come. They purchased the animals, so they raised flocks of sheep and goats, and they got very good price. And then when they sacrificed, where did the meat go? They took the meat, dried it up, and kept it, and ate it during the whole year. Dried up meat. So this was actually the source of income for them. وَالْبُدْنَا جَعَلْنَاهَا لَكُمْ مِنْ شَعَائِرِ اللَّهِ لَكُمْ فِيهَا خَيْرٌ فَاسْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهَا صَوَافٌ. So mention the name of Allah on them, making them stand in a row. فَإِذَا وَجَبَتْ جُنُوبُهَا. You know, a spear is pierced into the neck of the camel when he is standing. It is not, you know, zibah, lying down, no. A spear that pierces the neck. So a stream of blood gushes out. And when much of the blood has flown out, then the camel, you know, falls down on one side. Then now you can make the pieces of meat from that. فَإِذَا وَجَبَ جُنُوبُهَا, when they fall down on their sides, فَقُلُوا مِنْهَا, now eat from it. وَأَطْعِمُ الْقَانِيَ وَالْمُعْتَرِ, and feed also those also who are contented, poor but are not begging, and also who are begging. كَذَلِكَ سَخَّرْنَاهَا لَكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, in this way we have subjected them to you, so that you may be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا, neither the meat of these sacrificial animals reaches Allah, nor the blood. The meat you eat, the blood goes in vain. But today that doesn't go in vain. From that blood, you know, poultry feed is prepared and so many things. Everything is now used. But in the ancient time, blood, well, it went away, but meat was eaten. But to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, neither the meat nor the blood. لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا, it's neither their flesh nor their blood that reaches Allah. وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ, but to him reaches the piety if it is there in your hearts, taqwa. If you are God-fearing, that this thing reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَذَلِكَ سَخَّرَهَا لَكُمْ لِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ مَا هَدَاكُمْ, in this way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has subjected them to you, so that you should glorify Allah, magnify Him on the guidance that He has given you. وَبَشِّرِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, and O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, give good glad tidings to the believers. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, now this Suratul Hajj was revealed just before the Hijrah, the immigration from Makkah to Medina. So actually some of the ayat which are revealed here in this surah, there is a tradition that they were revealed during the journey that the Prophet took from Makkah to Medina. 7 to 10 days, during these people some of the ayat were revealed and they are included in the surah. Otherwise most of the surah is Makki. And these ayat which we are reading now, they are from among the ayat which were revealed during the journey from Makkah to Medina. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, because after Hijrah, you know, the armed conflict between the believers and the non-believers was to start. That stage of the struggle of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where jihad was now to be converted into qital fi sabilillah. So for this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making a promise beforehand. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, verily, Allah will defend those who believe in Him. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ خَوَّانٍ كَفُورٍ, Allah doesn't like those people who are treacherous and ungrateful. These Quraysh are treacherous, ungrateful. They have made this Kaaba a center of idolatry, which was built by Ibrahim and Ismail as a center of Tawheed. So actually Allah doesn't like them. Now Allah will help the believers against them. أُذِنَ لِلَّذِينَ يُقَاتَلُونَ بِأَنَّهُمْ ظُلِمُوا, permission is being given to those on whom war has been forced because they have been wronged. So many people forced to flee from Makkah, to leave their homes and hearts and families even, leaving families at the mercy of the wolves of Makkah. They are going. Why? Because they were not allowed to live there and worship one God. So, أُذِنَ لِلَّذِينَ, till this time, they were commanded not to retaliate. Take the persecution, whatever they may do to you, verbal persecution or physical persecution, you take it, but don't retaliate. As if the hands of the believers were tied up. كُفُّ أَيْدِيَكُمْ, keep your hands tied. But now your hands are opened. أُذِنَ لِلَّذِينَ يُقَاتَلُونَ بِأَنَّهُمْ ظُلِمُوا, because they have been wronged. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ نَصْرِهِمْ لَقَدِيرٌ, And definitely Allah is powerful to help them. الَّذِينَ أُخْرِجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ بِغَيْرِ حَقٍ. Those who have been expelled from their habitations and places without any crime of theirs, without any fault of theirs. What had they done to anybody? But they were forced to leave Makkah. إِلَّا أَنْ يَقُولُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ. Their only crime was that they said, we believe only in one Allah. Our Lord is Allah. وَلَوْلَا دَفُّ اللَّهِ النَّاسَ بَعْضَهُمْ بِبَعْضٍ. And had Allah not been removing certain people, through certain people, لَهُدِّمَتْ صَوَامِعُ وَبِيَعٌ. Then the monasteries and the churches, وَصَلَوَاتٌ and the synagogues, وَمَسَاجِدْ and mosques, in which يُذْكَرُ فِيهَ اسْمُ اللَّهِ كَثِيرًا, name of Allah is mentioned, they would have been demolished. They would have been pulled down. وَلَيَنْصُرَنَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will definitely help those who are helping Him. It is His deen. Whosoever is striving to make His deen supreme, he is helping Allah. And it is the mission entrusted to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make the deen of Allah supreme. هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ لِيُظْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ. So whosoever believer is striving for that cause, he is the helper of Allah and the helper of the messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah says, it's my duty, it's on me, that I must help those who are helping me. وَلَيَنْصُرَنَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَقَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ. Verily, Allah is strong, mighty. الَّذِينَ إِمَّكَّنَّاهُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Now, this ayah can be said to be the manifesto of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he was going towards Medina, it was as if he was going to take the charge. He was to become an informal ruler of Medina. He was entering as a ruler. Because both the tribes of Khazraj and Aus, the most of the chiefs of these tribes, they had accepted Islam. They are now believers. They have invited Muhammad to come here, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Their covenant was made in the Bayat of Ahmad Saniya. So here now the conditions are going to change. At Makkah, they were weak. They were small in number. So they couldn't do anything. Only privately worshipping Allah. Only bearing the hardships from the kuffar. Only continuing in giving the dawah to the people. But now they have the government, so to say, the authority, they have in their hands. So now what will they do? If they get the authority, what will be the attitude? الَّذِينَ إِمَّكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Those whom if we establish in the land, أَقَامُ الصَّلَاةِ. Number one, they will establish prayers. That is why the first ever work and task that Muhammad undertook sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after reaching Medina was the building of the mosque. To start and establish the center of prayer, which is the central pillar of Islam. وَآتَوُ الزَّكَاةَ. And then they will pay zakah. So that for the poor, there is a social security. Nobody goes hungry. Because now the rich people are paying and contributing towards the needs of the people who are not well off, who can't, you know, stand on their own feet. وَأَمَرُوا بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. And they will enjoin whatever is good. وَنَهَوْ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. And they will forbid from whatever is bad and indecent. وَلِلَّهِ عَاقِبَةُ الْأُمُورِ. And definitely, to Allah belongs the final results of all the matters. وَإِن يُكَذِّبُوكَ. Now, these are the ayat which I said, that they were revealed during the journey from Makkah to Medina. Now the rest is the same, the Makki surah. وَإِن يُكَذِّبُوكَ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if they are belying you, فَقَدْ كَذَّبَتْ قَبْلَهُمْ قَوْمُ نُوحٍ وَعَادٌ وَسَمُودُ وَقَوْمُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَقَوْمُ لُوتُ وَأَصْحَابُ مَدْيَنَ وَكُذِّبَ مُوسَى. Before you, so many messengers were belied, rejected, mocked at. The same was the condition with Nuh, then with the same was the behavior of the nation of Aad, and that nation of Samud, then the nation of Ibrahim, then the cities where Lut was sent, and then Ashab Madian, to whom Shaib was sent. وَكَذَّبْ قُذِّبَ مُوسَى. Musa was also belied. فَأَبْلَيْتُ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. But then I gave respite to the disbelievers, to the rejectors of the faith. ثُمَّ أَخَذْتُهُمْ. And then I seized them. فَكَيْفَ كَانَ النَّكِيرُ. So how was my punishment? What was the anjam? What was the result, end of the people of Nuh and people of Hud and people of Saleh and people of Shu'aib and Fir'aun and his hosts and all those? So this thing will happen here also. فَكَيِّ مِنْ قَرْيَةٍ أَهْلَكْنَاهَا. How many townships is there whom we destroyed? وَهِيَ ظَالِمَةٌ. And they were the evildoers. فَهِيَ خَاوِيَةٌ عَلَىٰ عُرُوشِهَا. Now they are down on their roofs. وَبَيْنِ مُعَتَّرَةٍ. And there are so many wells which are lying empty, ruined. وَقَصْرِ مَشِيد. So many palaces, lofty, but nobody is there to live in them. Go and see the palace in Granada. Go and see the mosque at Qartaba. Who is there? None. Who lived there? No traces now. So there are, go to the dwellings of Samud, in, you know, about 100 miles north of Medina. They carved out beautiful houses, big halls in the rocks, in the mountains. Very beautiful planning. And it is at least 5,000 years from this time. One of the earliest civilizations, Aad and Samud, one of the earliest civilization on this earth. أَفَلَمْ يَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. So have they not travelled in the land? فَتَكُونَ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ يَعْقِلُونَ بِهَا. And there should have been for them the hearts with which to understand and ponder. أَوْ أَذَانٌ يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا. Or ears with which to hear. فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَى الْأَبْصَارِ. Because these eyes don't go blind. وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَى الْقُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. Actually the hearts which are in the breasts and chests, they go blind. Abu Jahl was not blind of this eye. Abu Lahab was not blind of these eyes. He had very big, very prominent eyes. He was a very beautiful person. His, you know, nickname was Lahab. Why? Because he was just like a live fire coal, coal fire. Just like that. Very bright color. White and red, and very big eyes. So these are not more blind, but the blind becomes the heart. وَيَسْتَعْجِلُونَكَ بِالْعَذَابِ. And, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are these kuffar, they want that their chastisement should hasten. Now bring it, Muhammad, we are fed up. You are threatening us for the last 12 years. Chastisement will come, chastisement will come, chastisement will come. And we are fed up with this. Now bring it. يَسْتَعْجَلُونَكَ بِالْعَذَابِ. وَلَنْ يُخْلِفَ اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ. Allah is not going to go back on His promise. This azab would come, but إِنَّ يَوْمًا إِنَّ رَبِّكَ كَالْفِ سَنَةٍ مِمَّا تَعُدُّونَ. One day with your Lord is equal to 1,000 years according to your counting. So Allah's calendar is not your calendar. You are counting 10 years have passed. But if you compare these 10 years to 1,000 years, so what is it? Nothing. So Allah is giving them respite, but that chastisement would come. وَكَيِّ مِنْ قَرْيَةٍ أَمْرَيْتُ لَهَا. And how many township have I respited? وَهِيَ ظَالِمَةٌ. And that was evildoers. ثُمَّ أَخَذْتُهَا وَإِلَيَّ الْمَصِيرُ. Then I seized it, and to me is the return. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّمَا أَنَا لَكُمْ نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ. Say, O mankind, I am for you the warner, plain warner. فَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ. So those who come to believe and do good deeds, for them will be the forgiveness and generous sustenance. وَالَّذِينَ سَعَوْا فِي آيَاتِنَا مُعَاجِزِينَ. And those who strive against our revelations to frustrate them, to fail them, أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ الْجَحِيمِ. They are the companions of the hellfire. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ وَلَا نَبِيٍّ إِلَّا إِذَا تَمَنَّى أَلْقَى الشَّيْطَانُ فِي أُمْنِيَّتِهِ. And we didn't send before you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, any messenger or prophet. But the case has been that when they desired something, they planned, we should do like this and this and this. One thing is coming from Allah, there can be no doubt in it. But one is the planning of the prophet or the messenger. He is a man, he is a human being. He has to plan. But in his planning there can be errors. In the revelation there can be no error. It is protected. No shayateen can interfere with the revelation. Revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is 100% protected. But your own ijtihad, your own planning, your own desire, your own scheming, there can be errors. So Satan mixes something in it. إِذَا تَمَنَّى أَلْقَى الشَّيْطَانُ فِي أُمْنِيَتِهِ فَيَنْسَخُ اللَّهُ مَا يُلْقِي الشَّيْطَانُ. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cancels what is the ilqa of shaitan, what he has put down in it. ثُمَّ يُحْكِمُ اللَّهُ آيَاتِهِ. Then Allah strengthens His revelations. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ. And Allah is all-knowing, the all-wise. لِيَجْعَلَ مَا يُلْقِي الشَّيْطَانُ فِتْنَةً لِلَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ. But there is a wisdom in this also. Whatever shaitan casts, the Satan casts, it becomes a test and tribulation for those in whose there is a disease in their hearts. That is nifaq, weakness of iman. And whose hearts are hard, وَالْقَاسِيَةِ قُلُوبَهُمْ. Whose hearts have hardened. بَيْنَ الظَّالِمِينَ لَفِي شِقَاقٍ بَعِيدٍ. And definitely, these evildoers are in wide opposition. وَلَيَعْلَمَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْإِلْمَ أَنَّهُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ. And so that people who have been given the knowledge, true knowledge, they come and recognize this is the truth from their Lord. فَيُؤْمِنُوا بِهِ. So they believe in it. فَتُخْبِتَ لَهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ. And their hearts so humbly submit to it. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَهَادِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِلَىٰ صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. And verily Allah is the guider. He will guide those who come to believe to the straight path. وَلَا يَزَالُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِرْيَةٍ مِّنْهُ. And these people who are disbelieving, they will remain in doubt regarding this Quran and this revelation. حَتَّى تَاتِيَهُمُ السَّاعَةُ بَغْتَةً. Till that time, that sixth hour, the doomsday comes suddenly. أَوْ يَاتِيَهُمْ عَذَابُ يَوْمٍ عَقِيمٍ. Or before that qiyamah, before that sa'ah, there is some chastisement from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a barren day. الْمُلْكُ يَوْمَ يَزِلْ لِلَّهِ. On that day, all authority will be in the hands of Allah. الْمُلْكُ يَوْمَ يَزِلْ لِلَّهِ يَحْكُمُ بَيْنَهُمْ. He will judge between them, decide between them. فَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ فِي جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ. So whosoever would come there that they had believed and they had done good deeds, they will be in the gardens of bliss. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَكَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا فَأُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. As for those who had refused to accept and who had belied the revelations, our revelations, they are the those for whom there is a very humiliating chastisement. وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ قُتِلُوا. As for those who migrated for the sake of Allah, who were traveling from Makkah to Medina to make the hijrah, ثُمَّ قُتِلُوا. Then they were murdered, maybe in the way, during the journey, or after reaching Medina. وَمَاتُوا أَوْ مَاتُوا. Or they died, maybe someone might have died during their journey. لَيَرْزُقَنَّ اللَّهُ رِزْقًا حَسَنًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will definitely provide them with the best of provisions. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَهُوَ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ. And verily Allah is the best of providers. Now when they have started their journey of hijrah, so their reward is sure with Allah. Whether they reach Medina or not, they have started their journey, they have left their homes and hearts. So now their reward is assured. لَيُدْخِلَنَّهُمْ مُدْخَلًا يَرْضَوْنَهُ. And He will make them enter a place which they will like, paradise. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَعَلِيمٌ حَلِيمٌ. And definitely Allah is knowing and forbearing. ذَلِكُ. This is as it is. وَمَنْ عَاقَبَ بِمِثْلِ مَا أُوقِبَ بِهِ. And whosoever take a revenge, but equal to the infliction that was inflicted to him. Summa bughi alayhi, then again, something wrong is done to them, they are more oppressed. Layansurannahullah, Allah will definitely help him. Because he is being wronged. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَعَفُورٌ غَفُورٌ. Verily Allah is pardoning and forgiving. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يُولِجُ اللَّيْلَ فِي النَّهَارِ. And this is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the night to merge into the day. وَيُولِجُ النَّهَارَ فِي اللَّيْلِ. And makes the day merge into the night. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ بَصِيرٌ. And because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all-hearing, all-seeing. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ. This ayah appeared in the beginning also. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ وَأَنَّهُ يُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى وَأَنَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Again, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ. This is because Allah is the absolute truth. Every other thing can have some element of falsehood in it. Every other thing. But Allah is pure truth, the truth, absolute truth. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ وَأَنَّ مَا يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ هُوَ الْبَاطِلُ. And all those whom they are calling upon as false gods, they are batil. They are false. They have no existence whatsoever. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْكَبِيرُ. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very high, very great. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ أَنزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً. Don't you see? Have you not seen that Allah sent down water from the heaven? فَتُصْبِحُ الْأَرْضُ مُخْضَرَّةً. Then the earth which was lying barren now becomes green. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَطِيفٌ خَبِيرٌ. Verily Allah Ta'ala is subtle and aware of everything. لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. For him, to him belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَهُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدِ. And verily and surely and definitely, it is Allah who is self-sufficient. He needs nothing, needs none, no help whatsoever. And he is praiseworthy. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Have you not seen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has subjected to you everything that is in the earth? Serving you. You are utilizing them. You are exploiting them. Wal fulka tajri fil bahri bi amri. And these ships, they are, you know, floating in the seas with the command of Allah. Wa yumsiku as-samaa'a an taqa'a 'alaykum. And he is withholding the heaven lest it should fall upon you. Illa bi iznihi. Except with his permission. A time will come at the doomsday. This will burst. Is a sama'un shankat. When these skies and these heavens will be broken. But till that time, Allah is holding them. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَالْفُلْكَ تَجْرِي فِي الْبَحْرِ بِأَمْرِهِ وَيُمْسِكُ السَّمَاءَ أَن تَقَعَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِالنَّاسِ لَرَءُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. Surely Allah is for the human beings very gracious, merciful. وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَحْيَاكُمْ ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ. And he has given you life. And then he will put you to death. ثُمَّ يُحْيِيكُمْ. Then he will revive you. You are living today. Who has given you the life? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he will put you to death. He will take away life from you. But then the same Allah who has done this before, he can again revive you. يُحْيِيكُمْ. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَكَفُورٌ. But man is very ungrateful to his Lord. لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ جَعَلْنَا مَنْسَكًا هُمْ نَاسِكُوهُ. For every ummah, we appointed some devotional rites of sacrifice. And they pursue them. فَلَا يُنَازِعُنَّكَ فِي الْأَمْرِ. So, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, these people shouldn't quarrel with you in this matter. Because, you know, the rules of sacrifice of animals in Hajj and Eid al-Adha, they are different from the rules of sacrifice which were there for the Jews. Now, if they come and argue, why have you changed these rules? Well, for every ummah, we have fixed the rules. The form of salah for the former ummah was different from the form of salah that has been prescribed for us. The detailed rules of psalm for the former ummah were different from the rules of psalm which have been prescribed for us. So for every ummah, we have prescribed these sacrificial rites. So they shouldn't, therefore, quarrel with you concerning these things. وَدْعُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ. And O Muhammad, you keep on calling them towards your Lord. إِنَّكَ عَلَىٰ عَلَىٰ هُدٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Verily, surely, you are on the guidance, and the guidance which is very straight. وَإِنْ جَادَلُوكَ. And if they argue with you, they quarrel with you, فَقُلْ اللَّهُ عَلَمُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Say to them, Allah best knows what you are doing. Allah يَحْكُمُ بَيْنَكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فِي مَا كُنْتُمْ فِيهِ تَخْتَلِفُونَ. And Allah will judge between you on the day of judgment on all matters in which you had been differing. أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Don't you know that Allah knows whatever is in the earth, in the heaven and in the earth. إِنَّ ذَلِكَ فِي كِتَاب. Everything is written in a book. إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. And definitely this is very easy for Allah. It might seem difficult for you. How can it be possible? All the deeds of all the human beings written and recorded. How many deeds I perform daily. My, you know, every movement recorded. It could be unimaginable for people 1 century before. But now, you can have a video film of your life. Everything recorded. A tape of your voice. And every single word you utter is recorded. Now it is very easy to believe in these things. But imagine, about 200 years back, when there were no tape recorders, and when there were no photography, and no this filming and all this. But this was, they had to believe in it. That Allah records everything, everything. It is in a book, it's in a record. وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَمْ يُنَزِّلْ بِهِ سُلْطَانًا. And they are worshipping beside Allah those for whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not sent down any proof, any authority. وَمَا لَيْسَ لَهُمْ بِهِ عِلْمٍ. And for which they have no knowledge. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِن نَصِيرٍ. And for those evildoers, there will be no helper on the day of judgment. وَإِذَا تُتْلَىٰ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُنَا بَيِّنَاتٍ. And when our clear revelations are recited unto them, تَعْرِفُ فِي وَجُوهِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُ الْمُنْكَرِ. You can see and witness that on the faces of these kuffar, there is repugnance, anger. You are reciting Quran to them, and they are feeling anger. There is a reaction, repugnance. يَكَادُونَ يَسْتُونَ بِالَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِنَا. They are very near on rushing upon those who are reciting to them the ayat of Allah and killing them. يَسْتُونَ بِالَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِنَا. They are so angry. They are so displeased with these ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ أَفَأُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِشَرٍّ مِّن ذَلِكُمْ. Say to them, should I tell you what is more bad, worse than this? What you are feeling today, this anger, this repugnance, what is more bad than this? Annar, that fire in which you will be thrown. That is much worse. You are feeling the pain. Why these ayat are being recited to me? Why this, you know, revelations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are being communicated to me? But the pain of this hell, fire, when you will be thrown in, will be much greater. وَعَدَهَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. And Allah has promised that fire of hell to those who disbelieve. وَبَيْسَ الْمَصِيرِ. And that is a very bad place, a destination to return to. Now the last section of this surah is very, very profound, very comprehensive. The whole essence of the call of Quran, given in 6 ayat. This is one of the lessons of a selected course of study of the Quran that I, you know, edited about 30 years back. And all, you know, my movement that is actually based on that selected course of study of Quran. It comes to about equal to 2 parts of Quran, 1/15 Quran. But it contains the essence of Quran, the basic themes, the basic teachings. And this last section of Suratul Hajj is the, so to say, the central lesson of this selected course of study, which we shall inshallah study 1 hour later. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Quran al-Azim, wa nafani wa iyaakum bil ayati wa zikr al-hakim.
Allahu Akbar,
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.